This first video in the series is a short introduction to digestates. Why are digestates interesting? Digestates contain a range of plant nutrients and also have other beneficial properties. Digestates are already used extensively in agriculture, both to fertilise crops and also to add organic matter into the soil. So horticulture is another obvious area of use for digestates. Using digestates instead of using synthetic fertilisers has the potential to reduce the carbon footprint of food production. This video will cover four main points. How is digestate made? What are the main types of digestate? How is digestate used already? And also, I'll provide a summary of situations where digestates already show potential for use in horticulture. And by horticulture, we mean glasshouses, outside growing of vegetables, and so on. And on to the first question, how is digestate made? Organic materials are converted to biogas via the anaerobic digestion process. A photo of an anaerobic digestion plant, often abbreviated to AD, is shown here. There are at least 580 AD sites in the UK alone. This is for 2020. The AD process itself involves the breakdown of organic materials via microorganisms without oxygen, hence the term anaerobic. The biogas that is produced is mostly a mixture of methane and carbon dioxide. In the UK, the biogas tends to be used in two ways. Firstly, it can be burnt in an engine to generate electricity and heat. Sometimes the heat is used to heat offices or glasshouses. Secondly, it can be cleaned up. This is also called upgrading. And the clean gas is then injected into the gas grid. This upgrading involves the removal of carbon dioxide, as well as contaminants in the biogas, such as hydrogen sulfide or siloxanes. There are different types of organic materials used to feed the anaerobic digesters. Here is an example of some household food waste, which has been collected for anaerobic digestion in the UK. Digesting waste materials instead of sending them to landfill reduces methane emissions from landfill. Many countries have targets to reduce organic waste that is being sent to landfill, and using anaerobic digestion is an ideal way to make energy from waste. Some anaerobic digesters process on-farm organic materials, such as animal slurry, animal manure, vegetable processing residues, or purpose-grown crops. Other inputs include distillery and brewery residues. Some anaerobic digesters will use a mixture of different feedstocks combined together. These are generally mixed at the front end of the AD process. And now, going back to our diagram. The nutrient-rich digestate is the organic material that remains at the end of the anaerobic digestion process. The feedstock of anaerobic digesters is often consistent for that specific digester, but one digestate may have different feedstocks compared to the next. This is why the nutrient content of digestates is likely to vary from site to site. And I do have a separate video which goes into details about the nutrient contents of different digestates. In the UK, most digestate is applied to agricultural land. So this is a locally produced source of nutrients. This is now frequently replacing other types of fertiliser. Some other uses are starting to be considered, including horticulture. In the UK and other countries, there are regulatory controls in place for the production and use of digestates, particularly for digestates that are derived from food wastes and other animal byproducts, and this is generally to ensure their safety. In some cases, these regulations will limit what the digestates can be used for. I may tell you more about this in a separate video about digestate regulations. And now onto the three main types of digestate, and these are circled in blue on the photo. In some anaerobic digestion plants, the digestate that is produced is left as it is. It's not put through any post-digestion steps. This is called whole digestate. This whole digestate is generally a dark liquid with 3 to 10% dry matter. In some anaerobic digestion sites, the whole digestate is separated into two fractions. These are called separated liquor, which is the liquid fraction, and separated fibre, which is a solid fibrous fraction. There are a range of separation mechanisms, with a screw press separator shown here. This is what's commonly used in UK farm systems, where purpose-grown crops are used as some or part of the feedstock. These photos show liquor digestates from potato residues on the left and made from maize shown on the right. Here you can see really well how different feedstocks will influence the digestate properties. Here's some separated digestate fibre. This was produced from maize and rye silage. The volume and the moisture content of the fibre will vary depending on the separation technology that's used. Digestate solids are rich in organic matter, and as the name suggests, they are also high in fibre. This is why they're really popular with farmers for increasing the organic matter in their soils. And in the UK, most of the whole and liquor digestate is applied to agricultural land and grassland, as shown here. It's used as a valuable source of available nitrogen and also a range of other plant nutrients. The solid digestate fibre is also applied to farmland, adding organic matter and nutrients to improve the soil. In the UK, there are some restrictions on when and where some digestates are allowed to be applied. The reason for these restrictions is to aim to minimise the risk to water, as well as grazing animals, and the public that will then go on and consume the agricultural produce. In some countries, the separated fibre from specific input materials is dried and used as cattle bedding. Often the heap from the AD process is used for the drying mechanism. Another developing opportunity is for digestate fibre as a renewable engineered construction material. Some research is being done looking at medium density fibre board, MDF, and also wood plastic composite materials. We already know that digestates are used successfully to feed agricultural crops and to improve soils. As an extension of this, could digestates be used in horticulture as fertiliser, soil mulch, soil conditioner, or as a growing media ingredient? Over the last decade, there has been a lot of research to address this question, with the main potential uses for digestates that have been researched listed here. I'll give you a very brief overview now. One option is to use the whole or separated liquor fraction as a fertiliser for soil or peat-based growing systems, such as to grow strawberries or tomatoes. In the UK, there are at least two digestate-based liquid fertilisers, called biofertilisers, on the market specifically for gardeners. Research trials have investigated the use of liquid digestates in commercial hydroponic systems. This requires a lot of work to dilute the digestate and add other ingredients to create the perfect balance, with some promising results in terms of plant growth and plant yield and quality. This photo shows a vertical hydroponic system in London. The lettuces are growing in diluted digestate from a micro anaerobic digester. In this growth trial, the lettuces grew well, as you can see. Could nutrient solutions containing digestates be used in these space-saving systems at a larger scale to grow these crops in the future? And now on to solid digestate fibre. Could digestate fibre also be used as a growing media ingredient to replace peat? Traditionally, peat has been used as the basis for growing media, including multi-purpose composts. Peat is very light, inert, consistent, and has excellent moisture retaining qualities. Unfortunately, peat is not a renewable resource, and destroying peat bogs has a negative impact on the environment, and this includes wildlife, carbon emissions, and water quality. there are national targets to reduce peat use in horticulture and to replace it with sustainably sourced alternatives. Research work to date has shown that digestate fibre does have real potential to be a part of the solution for peat replacement. The thing about solid digestate fibre is that it typically needs to be mixed with other ingredients to support plant growth. In agriculture, this happens naturally as the digestates are generally applied over a large area of soil, and often they are mixed in with the soil as well. Research trials use digestate mixed with other growing medium ingredients, and these include wood chip, wood fibre, bark, coir or peat. This mixing around helps in regulating the right water holding capacity, bulk density, structural properties, electrical conductivity and nutrient balance. Quite a lot of things to get right there. Results from trials are promising in terms of plant growth and quality. Where experimental mixes are made that do not match the profile of standard products, the plant growth and quality tends to be less good, often resulting in lower yields. Achieving the right mix for sale as a commercial product can be quite a fine art. In the UK, digestate fibre produced from crops is already on the market as a soil improver or soil mulch. Soil improvers are normally mixed into the soil while the mulch is left on the surface to help suppress weeds. Both soil improver and soil mulch should improve soil structure, water retention, provide nutrients and organic matter, and promote healthy soil. This photo shows an example of a digestate product launched recently in the UK in 2020. This is providing popular with local Cambridgeshire gardeners. And in summary, research results do show that digestates can be used to grow edible horticultural crops, such as tomatoes, strawberries and lettuce, and also a range of ornamental plants at the trial scale. These trials go into some lengths to ensure that commercial growing parameters are matched. A particularly tricky method is hydroponics, where plants are grown in a nutrient solution without growing media. So in this hydroponic situation, the balance of nutrients, pH and electrical conductivity needs to be adjusted for each particular crop. Similarly, peat-free growing media based on digestate fibre are not without their pitfalls either. Easy wins are the use of digestates as a soil improver and also as a soil mulch. And the scientific evidence shows that digestates can in theory be used as a biofertiliser and as a soil improver to produce high quality food with reduced chemical fertiliser inputs. And this is good news, as reducing emissions to produce food more sustainably is what my channel is all about. Following on from this will be more videos on using digestates in horticulture, including one on the use of liquid digestates as fertiliser, and then also one on solid digestate fibre for growing media, and also a research trial growing strawberries with liquid digestates, which will go in a bit more detail too. Check out my channel for videos on digestate use in agriculture, which is part of my Reducing Ammonia Emissions series. And finally, here are the references used to create this video. Thank you for listening today.